This video isn't a tutorial. This isn't a super slow breakdown of Framer and how to use all of the features in it. Instead, this video is going to show you how to become a person who can execute their ideas and make them into reality very, very quickly. I love magic, and in my video about becoming a conference speaker, I talk about how performing as a magician has helped me gain confidence and has given me something really interesting to speak about at conferences. I also love watching magic shows, but I have a problem. There's no central place online to find really good recordings of live magic shows. Sure, you can search through YouTube and find clips of magicians speaking on talk shows, but there's no like repository of watching a full show from beginning to end. And I know there are great recordings of live magic shows out there. So I thought I'd make this. Imagine something like Netflix or Next Up. If I'd had this idea a few years ago, I'd have probably made some designs in Figma, played around with it a bit, and then just left it and forgotten about it. But it's 2024, and I think we can make a real live website using Framer and the Framer CMS. So this is the website I came up with. I'll show you what it looks like. You can scroll down and view different shows and kind of scroll through them. And if you click on one, it links you to a website which takes you either to a place where you can buy the show or subscribe to watch it. Or if it's just on YouTube, you can just start watching it straight away. Now, I'll be honest, I designed these cards in Figma and then I used the plugin to copy them into Framer. I'll drop a link to that plugin in the description if you want to try it out. And I've made these using Framer components, which I don't think is the best way of doing this because I'm not using the CMS properties and I'm finding making them in this way will just take too long. I really want to get it set up in a database or Airtable or CMS. But yeah, you can see I've just used the basic carousel component. So if you haven't seen that, if you just go to insert up here, you can find loads of different pre-made elements for you. And then I did layouts for tablet and phone, and they kind of just work out of the box. So yeah, I'm really excited for this. I think it's come out really well. And yeah, you can just go and try it for yourself right now if you visit this URL. Here's why I'm so excited about this. I think tools like Framer, which allow you to take your ideas and without any code, any knowledge of code, make them a reality, are so, so exciting. I always think about something called time to value. So in startup books, people always talk about this kind of idea of an MVP, which means minimum viable product. And the best way I've seen an MVP explained is using this diagram. You're focusing on bringing value to your end user as early as possible. You're not thinking that you're gonna make a $1 billion company from the off. You're just trying to get something which solves a real problem that people have. And I think the best way to do this is find a problem that you yourself have. So that's what this magic website is for me. This was a problem I had, and without any code, I've made a solution for it. With this idea in particular, there's like so little chance that something like this could go on to make money. And even if it did make money, there's no way to know if it would be worth the investment or even what the business model would be for it. And this kind of indecision stops a lot of people from getting started on making their ideas. And I think that indecision shouldn't hold people back. With Framer, I can still tinker around with UI design, which is what I love to do. But at the end of it, I just have to press a button and I've made a live site and I can share that with the entire internet. This is what lots of people in startup communities call small bets. And they say it's important to make as many small bets as possible. At the beginning, it's important to try for quantity over quality. You should pursue lots and lots of different ideas with the hope that one day one of them will work out. So don't worry, don't be precious about your ideas and keep them close to your chest. Just go and start and try building them all out and see where they take you. What I'm going to do with this website is I'm going to change up the content. So instead of using Framer components, it uses a CMS, which will allow me to add way more content way more quickly. I'm going to put in an email pop-up and use some basic analytics. And then maybe if I see some significant growth month on month, I'll look into one of those monetization strategies, but maybe I won't and I'll move on to the next thing. And that's okay. I think if you take one thing away from this video, let it be this. Don't wait to start working on your next project. Start now, build your ideas now. So if you do want to go check out the site, I've called it OnStage. Like I said, there's a link to it in the description and I'm really proud of it. I threw it together quite quickly, but I think it looks really sleek. It works well across all devices. It's super fast to load. And yeah, you can go watch some really, really good magic shows using this. Just before I sign off, I've got a really small favor to ask. I'm trying to grow out this YouTube channel this year. If you like these videos, please do just hit the like button below, hit subscribe. That really helps me out. And if you have a particular type of video or some kind of thing you want to learn about to do with design, please do let me know in the comments. I'd love to make videos that you guys want to see. I'm interested in all kinds of design. So if there's someone you think I should be speaking to, maybe we could do an interview over Zoom or in person. I would love that. So thank you so much for watching. I'll leave it here for now, and I'll see you on the next one. Cheers.